Hello everyone, my name is General Legoshi and welcome back to yet another in our ongoing series on lesser known VR chat worlds. Some of my previous entries have broken 1,000 views, which is absolutely fantastic news. I am so excited to see this series is so popular with so many players, and that's really motivated me to keep exploring and making these for you all. So thank you to everyone who continues to watch and enjoy this series. Our next entry is the top most beautiful worlds in VR chat, except this episode comes with a twist. Beautiful worlds is a very general, very abstract kind of topic, so I would not be surprised if you see repeat episodes of this in the future, because there's so many worlds to list. I define beautiful worlds as worlds with aesthetic as their primary feature, so there may not be much to do in these worlds other than gather your thoughts and maybe talk to your friends, but hey, I think that's what the game is all about. So, here's my list. Purity is almost eerie in its setting. On a cliff among an evergreen forest in the late afternoon rain, Purity is where I sometimes find myself going to relax to simply listen to the rain and watch as the wind blows through the trees. The start of the world has you staring into presumably your car's headlights as it sits idle on the cliff road that's taking you here. The wind blows and heavy rain comes down as you climb higher on the cliff following a secluded path, wherein you can then sit down and enjoy the view of the mountains and the trees until the horizon. Purity is a great place to gather your thoughts or talk privately to a friend, and for that reason, it makes it onto this week's list. There's a good chance that you may have visited this world if you were around for its release back in roughly September 2021. But if you were not, there's an equally good chance that you've not yet had the absolute pleasure of exploring it. Aquarius is more of a science project than a VR chat world, and it does this job beautifully. From the neon lights to the bioluminescent plants, you're immediately greeted with a sense of quality from the moment you step into Aquarius. But truly, a mesmerizing sight awaits you if you step into the main lobby. Marine life fills the blue world above you. Sharks, stingrays, whales, and entire schools of fish go about their daily lives in a beautiful yet educational showcase of the absolute best our blue planet has to offer. Multiple different environments make up this world, and each is as beautiful as the last, and it is absolutely worth a visit if you want to shock and awe your friends. The most solemn thing in this world is that perhaps future generations will rely on technology such as this to even come into contact with sea life, and it serves as a sincere reminder about how incredible our planet is and equally how amazing virtual reality is as an educational tool as much as it is a visual spectacle. If anything, when I visited, I found myself thinking hard about our environmental impact. If you visit anytime soon, maybe you'll find yourself doing the same. With the release of Elden Ring, I thought I should maybe include this world. Dark Souls 3 Plaza has taken some inspiration from the game's Boreal Valley region, an open, circular plaza situated in the middle of looming and awe-inspiring snowy mountains. The aurora borealis dances in the sky between the peaks, the stars glimmer in the inky black sky, and the moon casts a dim light down onto everything below. Tiny flakes of snow also descend onto the map, giving it a quiet beauty you scarcely find anywhere else in the game. The aptly named Ship in Clouds world is probably the closest you'll ever come to arguing that VRChat is a piece of art. A reflective, water-like surface coats the ground, reflecting shimmers on all the clouds above. The pink sunlight bursts through a distant cloud, illuminating the map in a pink, romantic light. There's various settings you can play around with to make this world really pop, as well as some cool notes by the creator where you load in. But honestly, I feel like I should just let this world do the talking. So here's a short compilation of everything you can expect to find. I really had to rack my brain to even find this world, as it has been months since I found it. Hurja's Lake is an absolutely gorgeous map that almost nobody ever visits, which is a real shame. A lake house pavilion sits quietly on the water as blue fireflies twinkle above the surface. There are torches everywhere, and the unique art style of this world really makes it feel like something from Nintendo, or perhaps from our childhoods, and that's something I absolutely love. There's also all kinds of settings to adjust, including making it rainy instead, giving the map a whole new atmosphere entirely. Check it out today, as I find relaxing and chilling out in this world one of the best uses of your VR chat time, other than maybe getting hammered on weekends and playing silly game worlds with your friends. A bit of personal bias here, but Lucifer M-Star truly does create by far my favourite worlds, and his latest, Winter Company, is no exception. A large, cosy house situated in London with a hybrid of Scandinavian and Oriental architecture, Winter Company is an absolutely stunning indoor world, which is a slight contrast to everything else on my list. Every room here is masterfully crafted for peak coziness, and there are so many rooms to get lost in, each with its own purpose, vibe, and things to do. Winter Company is also a great suggestion for anyone looking for a new homeworld, as it seems an ideal place to host gatherings of friends, either to watch movies, play games, have a drink, or just mess around. Whatever the case, Winter Company had to be on my list for nailing the balance between beauty and functionality. And we have reached the end of this week's Worlds. What did you think of my picks? Do you see yourself visiting them anytime soon? Let me know in the comments below, as well as any controversial opinions that you may have about my picks. Thanks again to everyone for watching, and if you'd like to stay up to date with these kind of videos in the future, please feel free to subscribe and hit that bell. I promise I won't spam you. This is General Legoshi, over and out.